We're going to bring in GMA legal analyst Dan Abrams. And Dan, when we hear Bill Stanton, his last remarks to Abby about the mother doesn't want to be discounted, what do you make of that?
Yeah, I think she wants to be ruled out. I think that after the relationship we've seen where the police came and said they're not cooperating anymore, and then they have to come out and do interviews, I think it's smart for the parents to say, we're going to do whatever it takes, however long it takes, to assure the authorities that they can look elsewhere. And I think that's a smart thing for them to say.
In the last couple of days, we've seen video being released. Yesterday, it was the surveillance video of the mom, and she's out shopping. Everything is normal. She's buying baby supplies. And then we see these sweet home videos, and you can hear the mother just sweetly talking to the baby. What do they look for in those
videos? I think the investigators are going to look a lot more at the surveillance tape than the home videotapes. I mean, you know, in every case, even when someone has ended up doing something horrible to a child, you can probably find some video at some point where someone's being kind to a child. It's not to say that it's not relevant. It's just for investigators, it's not going to be a big issue. On the other hand, that surveillance tape from only hours earlier, the fact that she's buying in bulk to some degree, diapers and wipes and other things, I think is helpful to her to say, you know, this sure doesn't look like someone who was about to do something bad to the child. Now, there's always the possibility of accidents, et cetera, but I think that surveillance tape is relevant to investigators.
The parents at first very open in talking to the media and talking to the police, and then they backed off of both, and now I know you're going to be going out there this weekend and you're going to be talking to the parents. Good or bad that they're, how they've handled this?
Well, look, I think the big problem for them was when the police came and announced the parents are no longer cooperating. In a case like this, when there's an announcement the parents are no longer cooperating, immediately suspicion starts to grow. So I think it was very smart for the parents to come out and say, in effect, there was a misunderstanding, we're going to get back in there, we're going to work with the authorities. But look, working with the media is significant in missing child cases. It's not just to defend yourself, it's also to draw attention to it so that there are other people out there looking for the child. I mean, in a high-profile case, you can suddenly get an army of volunteers helping you, and that's the reason to go to the media. And I think that it's smart of the family to be balancing, but they have to make sure that the authorities are continuing to say they're helping, they're working with us, we're trying to rule them out, etc. And then secondarily is this media strategy.
And again, you'll be talking with them this weekend. I know you'll be filling in. We'll see you with Bianna this weekend on GMA.
Great.
All right, Dan, thank you.